All right, so first up here is a 1971 Denver Minted Washington Quarter. Now, this is an error coin. You can see that it has a brokerage, and this quarter was struck on a 5-cent planchet. So if you find anything like this in your pocket change, definitely hold on to it because you probably want to get it graded by a coin grading company. Now, we see here on one side, the quarter looks exactly normal. You know, it looks fine, nothing wrong with it. And then we see that error there on the reverse of the quarter. Now, this 1971 quarter sold for over $2,500. Next up is another 1971 D Washington quarter. It's been broad struck. It also has a straight clip there. You can see there on the right side of the Washington quarter. And this quarter here, because of that error, sold for over $45. So not a lot of money, but still a $45 quarter. Also, for the 1971 D and 1971, you want to look for a double die reverse. So look for doubling on the lettering United States of America as well as quarter dollar. You want to do that with a USB coin microscope, which I have available on couchcollectibles.com. If we take a look here at a 1971 D, you can see on the coin slab it says DDR. That means double die reverse. There's doubling on the lettering, and it's graded at an extra fine 40. So it's not graded at a mint state grade or an extremely high grade. It's actually been circulated a little bit, but the coin still has value. This coin sold for over $1,000. That's why you always want to search your pocket change for these rare coins. Now, if we look at the same type of coin, a 1971 double die reverse, now this one is graded at about uncirculated 58, so it's got a little bit higher grade than the last coin, but it has the same type of error. It's doubling on the back of the coin, and that's why this 1971 quarter sold for over $1,300. But if you really want to go talk about some big money, then we talk mint state grade coins. So if you're not familiar with coin grading, I have a whole video on that. Just type in Couch Collectibles coin grading on YouTube and you will find those videos. The coin grading scale only goes up to 70. This coin here is graded at a mint state 65. So it has a very, very high grade. Now it has that double die reverse. And this coin, you go from a $1,000 coin with a lower grade to this coin with an extremely high grade. This quarter here sold for over $8,800. So you see the difference of $7,000 just depending on the condition of the coin. They both have that double die, but the condition is one's better than the other. So that's what's going to determine its value ultimately at the end of the day. Now back to an error coin. This is a simple type of error coin. It's just a defective clad layer on the obverse of the coin. So we see the copper inner core of the quarter on the left side of this 1971 Denver minted quarter. And this coin sold for over $20. Next up is a 1971 D Washington quarter that has been struck on a 10-cent blank planchet. So basically, it's a quarter that was struck on a dime, essentially. So this quarter here sold for over $180. Now, if we look at a quarter that was struck on a penny, a 1970, actually, this might not be a 1971. It does not have the one there at the end of the date. But anyways, this quarter here was struck on a penny, a 1-cent planchet, and it sold for over $550. Here's just another example of a quarter that was struck on a dime, a 1971 quarter on a dime, and this quarter sold for over $345. Now, obviously, these types of errors are very noticeable to look for in your pocket change. You wouldn't need a coin microscope for those. If we look at a very high-graded coin that has no errors on it, it's just an extremely high-graded 1971 quarter. It is the Denver Mint, the D Mint mark there, and it's graded at a mint state 68, so nearly a perfect coin. Like I said, the coin grading scale only goes up to 70. This is at a 68, and this coin here sold for over $4,000. $4,000. Now this next one's pretty cool. This is a 1971 D that was struck on a Liberia 25-cent planchet. So here's an example of the coin that it was actually struck on. That's what the coin was supposed to be. However, the Washington quarter design was struck on it, and that's why this coin sold for over $180. Now if we look at another 1971 that was struck on a 1-cent planchet, a copper planchet, it is graded at a mint state 62. 1971 D Washington quarter sold for over 1,000 $200. Now also on the 1971D, there are two different type of reverses. So two different backs of the coins. We got a type G right here and a type H. So if you look at the type G, you would notice that the arrowheads are being nearly embedded within the leaf while the leaf extends above the arrows. So if we look here at the other one, you see that that is not the case. So we see the arrows are different from the type H and the type G. See the leaf and the arrows back and forth, back and forth. So those are gonna determine which reverse you have on your quarter. Now, if we move on to a 1971 high-graded coin, now this one is the no mint mark, so it doesn't have any mint mark, Philadelphia minted Washington quarter. It's graded at a mint state 67. That is why the coin is valuable, and this coin sold for nearly $1,000. It sold for actually $995 to be specific, or just over that, but nearly a $1,000 quarter. Next up is one of my favorites of this video. This is pretty cool. I'm pretty sure I put this in one of my coin videos before. It is a 1971D Washington quarter that has an elamination error on it. So that is pretty cool. We see that there on the front of the Washington quarter. And actually, if we go to this next image here, you can see that the fragment that was on that quarter, the struck fragment, bam, right there. So that is pretty rare to have both pieces like that. That is awesome that this individual was able to get both of those graded. Now, this quarter here with the fragment sold for over $235. Moving right along to a 1971 Washington quarter. Now this one here has been struck 70% off center. But not only that, it was struck on a Philippines 10 centimos planchet. So very, very interesting here. If you find anything like this in pocket change, obviously it's gonna be very noticeable. It's gonna be harder to find things like this because anyone that finds this in their pocket change is gonna take it out of circulation. They're gonna know it's an error right away just by looking at it. However, there are errors. Like I showed you the double die reverse, you can look for that, that not many people look for. Now, this coin here sold for over $560 because of that mint error. Can't forget about the 1971S proof. Now, there is a big difference between proof coins and regular business strike coins. You can see this proof coin here has a mirror-like finish to it. It is very, very detailed. I go more in the depth in my proof coin video, so just type in proof coins couch collectibles on YouTube and you will find those videos. Now, this proof coin is a very high-graded coin. It's graded at a proof 69 deep cameo. So like I said, the coin grading scale only goes up to 70. This is at a 69, so nearly a perfect coin. This quarter sold for over $4,300. $4,300. If you guys want some coin collecting supplies, go to couchcollectibles.com. Link is down in the description of this video. And don't forget to subscribe in the middle. Check out the videos to the left of me. And until tomorrow, I'll see you all in the comment section below. This is Couch Collectibles, and this is where I disappear.